The RTX 4090 laptop GPU uses the same die as the RTX 4080 desktop graphics card. So then, why do they have different names? Is this just an attempt to mislead us? I've compared both in 23 games at 4K, 1440p, and 1080p resolutions to find out. Both GPUs use the same AD103 die, so they've got the same amount of CUDA, Tensor, and RT cores. They've both got a 256-bit memory bus and 16 gigs of VRAM, but the desktop card uses faster GDDR6X memory. The desktop card also has a higher power limit, so it's able to hit higher clock speeds as a result. So both of these technically have the same GPU inside, but the desktop card has faster memory and it can use more power. More power equals more heat, and I mean, just look at the size of this thing. The desktop card clearly has more space for cooling. It's like twice as thick as the, actually, sorry, more like three times, if not four times as thick as this laptop. So yeah, it's no surprise that it's able to use more power. I feel like I could kill someone with this thing. The RTX 4090 laptop GPU can actually run as low as 80 watts, and this graph shows the difference in TimeSpy graphics score at different power levels. Maxed out at 175 watts, the 4090 laptop hits 23,000 points, while the desktop card was around 28,300 points. A 23% higher score for the desktop, but it needs an 83% higher TGP to achieve this. To do this testing, I've used MSI's Titan GT77 laptop, which is capable of running the RTX 4090 laptop GPU right up to 175 watts with dynamic boost. So it represents a best case laptop 4090. I don't actually have the Titan here anymore, so it's not sitting next to me, but this is still a full powered 4090 laptop. I didn't actually test with this machine, it's just here for show. Along with the RTX 4080 graphics card, the desktop system has Intel's Core i9-13900K processor, which was chosen as it has the same amount of cores, threads, and cache as the laptop CPU. I've also tested it with 32 gigs of DDR5 5600 memory with the exact same timings as the laptop. There are always going to be differences between desktop and laptop parts. That's just the way it is. But by using CPUs with similar specs and the same memory speeds, I believe I've been able to reduce these differences as much as possible so that we can just focus on the GPU difference. The desktop card was using significantly more power than the laptop in two different games. Control at 4K max settings was drawing 69% more power on the desktop, not so nice, while Cyberpunk 2077 at 4K ultra settings was using 66% more power. Despite using more power, the desktop card was running cooler. Not really too surprising considering it's got a far larger cooler stock to it, but the laptop wasn't really that much warmer. More power allows the desktop card to reach higher clock speeds in both games. But despite the desktop card offering more performance, the laptop GPU actually wins in terms of power efficiency. This shows how many frames each system produces per 1 watt of power. The laptop might not hit as high raw FPS numbers, but it's doing better relative to its power consumption. Let's get straight into the 23 game comparison, starting with Cyberpunk 2077. I've got the 1080p results down the bottom, 1440p in the middle, and 4K up the top, with the laptop GPU below the desktop GPU. At 4K, the desktop GPU was reaching a 20% higher average frame rate, but remember that it was using 66% more power in order to pull this off, and that's why the laptop was more power efficient. I've also tested the higher ray tracing ultra preset, but as this is quite intensive, I've also set DLSS to quality mode and enabled frame generation. The desktop had a larger 25% lead at 4K now, but the laptop was still playable at above 60fps, assuming we count generated frames. Microsoft Flight Simulator was close to 60fps on the laptop at 4K ultra settings, but the desktop was 29% faster in this one. This is a single player game where latency doesn't really matter much, so if you wanted to use DLSS and frame generation, then these are the differences. Assassin's Creed Valhalla had the
smallest difference out of all 23 games tested at 4K, where the desktop 4080 was only around 11% or 9 FPS faster compared to the laptop 4090. The difference in average FPS wasn't that big in Dead Space either, with the desktop card just 9 FPS here too, a 17% lead in this case. But check out the 1% lows. These measure the dips in performance, and the laptop's 1% lows are way behind the desktop's at all three resolutions. This behavior was also seen in Doom Eternal at all resolutions, Forza Horizon 5, and Rainbow Six Extraction. It's something I've noticed on a number of Intel 13th Gen HX laptops in certain games, and in many cases, a lower core count 13700H actually ends up performing better, which tells me that all 24 CPU cores might not be getting enough power in the laptop. I might have to do a comparison with some E-cores disabled to find out. Red Dead Redemption 2 was tested with the game's benchmark. The 4090 laptop GPU was still well above 60 FPS at 4K max settings without upscaling techniques like DLSS. Not bad at all, and the desktop card was only 22% faster. A Plague Tale Requiem had some of the biggest differences between the two at 4K, with the desktop 30% faster, but it did feel a bit stuttery on the laptop. Turning on DLSS and frame generation definitely made it play much nicer, but the desktop card was of course still better than the laptop. Alright, the desktop 4080 graphics card was always beating the laptop 4090. You get it. Instead of wasting your time talking through the rest of the 14 games that I've tested, I'll instead just quickly skip through the rest of the results on screen now. So feel free to pause the video if you want a closer look at any of the other games tested. I think it's important to test a wide selection of games so that we can get an accurate picture of the average performance differences to make the fairest possible conclusion. In other words, more data equals more better. Let's look at those average differences next. On average, over all 25 games tested, at 1080p, the RTX 4080 desktop GPU was about 24% faster when compared to the RTX 4090 laptop GPU. Basically, this graph shows how much percent faster the 4080 desktop was in each game. Things don't change too much at the higher 1440p resolution. The 4080 desktop card was still 24% faster compared to the 4090 laptop in our 23 game selection. The individual results move around a bit at the higher 4K resolution, but once we average all 23 results together, the desktop 4080 was still about 24% faster compared to the 4090 laptop, much the same as the 23% higher TimeSpy graphics score we saw earlier. Just for comparison, when I recently compared the 4080 desktop card against a 4080 laptop, there was a much larger gap, with the 4080 desktop card performing 45% better in a similar selection of games. The 4080 desktop and 4090 laptop were definitely closer together, but the desktop still has a clear advantage due to its faster memory, higher power limit, and more room for cooling. The difference was similar in content creator workloads like Blender, where the 4080 desktop was scoring 24% higher than the 4090 laptop in the classroom test. The gap was smaller in V-Ray, with the 4080 desktop scoring 12% higher in the CUDA test and 11% higher in the ray tracing test. Video editing with DaVinci Resolve had a higher 29% score with the 4080 desktop though.
So the desktop 4080 was better than a laptop 4090 in every workload. So what about the price difference? Prices and availability will change over time, so check the links below the video for updates and sales. And speaking of sales, make sure you check out my website gaminglaptop.deals to get the best deal on your next gaming laptop. We update it every day with the latest deals.
Right now, we're looking at around $3,335 for a brand new PC with similar components to what I've tested here. Obviously, you could get a cheaper motherboard, power supply, CPU cooler, case, and less SSD space to lower the price even further while getting similar performance in games. But this is a similar configuration to what I've tested here. I mean, just getting the cheapest 4080 currently available instead would save you $200. The cheapest RTX 4090 laptops seem to be a similar amount, but don't forget these cheaper options likely have lower GPU power limits and won't perform quite as well compared to the Titan, which is much more expensive at $5,300. And honestly, kind of a ripoff compared to other great performing 4090 laptops out there. Razer's Blade 18, for instance, also has a full powered 4090 and would still perform well for $800 less. And that's Razer we're talking about, not exactly known for being budget friendly. The desktop setup is obviously winning from a cost per frame perspective. It costs much less money while also offering more performance. Granted, the desktop would cost more if you also need to add on a keyboard, mouse, or monitor, which have not been included, and those are all built into the laptop. You could argue the desktop has more value in future too, because you could easily take out the graphics card in a few years and upgrade the system. Meanwhile, you'd have to replace the whole laptop.
Ultimately, for the most part, it's going to depend on whether or not you need portability, and how much you're willing to pay to get maximum performance on the go. The 4090 laptop does actually offer a nice gen-on-gen performance improvement compared to the best laptops available last year, as shown in this comparison. But that's not the point. The point is the confusing naming, despite both of these having the same GPU die. Hang on, this thing's too big, I don't have enough room. Alright, anyway, it makes you wonder why they didn't just name the 4090 laptop GPU a 4080. Personally, I think this would have been a much better move, given they're both using the same AD103 die anyway, even if there are other differences over here like faster memory and more power. Adding an M onto the end and calling it a 4080M would have been icing on the cake. Instead, it looks like Nvidia have chosen to use the 4090 name to represent the best they've got to offer. So with this being the fastest laptop GPU currently available, it seems like they've just given it their best 4090 name. And I can understand it from that point of view, but it doesn't mean that I agree with it. You can't deny that it would be far less potentially misleading for the consumer just to have both of these named 4080 because they've got the same die inside. But here we are, and now you know the difference. Check out more of my laptop versus desktop comparisons next. I've compared the 4090 laptop against the 4090 desktop and 4080 desktop against a 4080 laptop. And as you'll see, the performance differences are quite a bit bigger than what we've seen in this video, because despite having the same names, there is actually a difference in the GPU dies there.